Hey guys, it's Bree. So today's video is going to be on my tips for inserting a menstrual cup, and I genuinely can't believe I haven't done this video before, but I haven't because I looked through my videos and I couldn't find it, so today I'm going to do it for you guys. So my first tip is relax. If you're really tense and, you know, just panicking about it, it's going to make it really difficult for you to get your menstrual cup in, and you're not going to be able to do it, and you're going to get frustrated, and believe me, I did this, it's just not good. Relax, and a good time to perhaps try it is after you've had a bath. When you've had a bath, obviously you're nice and warm, you're nice and relaxed, it's much easier to get your cup in, and I think in fact that's how I managed to get my cup in the first time. Another tip is don't do a dry run. A dry run is when you try inserting your menstrual cup for the first time when you're not on your period. It's perfectly safe to do, there's nothing dangerous about it, but it can be a little bit harder and you'll definitely need to use lubricant, I think, if you're doing that. The reason is because when you're on your period, the blood is naturally lubricating your vagina, and your vagina is also a little bit more stretchy, so it's easier to insert. So don't try a dry run, wait till you're on your period and insert it then. Tip number two is something I've already mentioned, that's lubricant. Now there are many different kinds of lubricant you can actually use. My three favourite to use are Yes Lubricant, coconut oil, and KY jelly. KY jelly is probably the most available lubricant. It must be a water-based lubricant, which is why KY jelly is probably the best if you just want to get it from anywhere. Coconut oil is good if you want to use a lubricant that is not really shouting out lubricant. You can get coconut oil again in any health store, and I think most supermarkets stock it now. It must be 100% coconut oil though. They say things like it needs to be cold pressed or virgin, whatever. It doesn't actually matter. As long as it's coconut oil, it's fine. And got nothing else in it. And the other thing you can use is Yes Lubricant. This is the little lubricant I have at the moment. It works really well and I really like it, and it's water-based and it's also organic and natural. Lubricant will make it easier for you to insert your cup to begin with. Even if you don't need to continue using it after the first time, it's a good idea to have it there just in case, because it really can make it a lot easier that first time you're trying to insert it. I use lubricant right from the beginning, and honestly, the first time I tried without it, it was really difficult, and as soon as I started using it, it made everything much easier. I still use it now, but I could probably get away with using my cup without it. I just find it's a lot easier to slide in if I have lubricant on my cup. So when I'm using lubricant, this is the punch down fold. I have a video on all the different folds you can do, but this is the punch down fold. If I was to cover this cup with lubricant, what I'd usually do is take my Yes Lubricant bottle, squeeze a little bit out onto my bathroom sink, then take my finger and dab it around the rim here, along the edge here, and also along the underside here. This is all I need to do in order to allow me to slide this in, and it's literally one little drop of lubricant is all you need to help this cup in. Once it's in, it should pop open easily, and you can push it up. My third tip for inserting menstrual cups is to try different folds. Again, as I said before, I have a different video for this, but there are a couple of different folds you can do that will help you to insert your menstrual cup. If you're having trouble with your cup opening, you might want to try a fold like the diamond fold or the labia fold. I'm going to show you the labia fold right now, but again, go and watch that video that I've already done on the different folds you can use for a menstrual cup, as I'll go through them all. But this is the labia fold. You pinch the side here and basically push this into the side of the cup like that. So you can see here, this cup is quite firm, the ruby cup, so it's a little bit more difficult to do. But you can see there's the hole. It's kind of just squished down on itself. This makes it easier because once you've inserted this cup, if it's still a bit stuck, you can hook your finger under the rim, and basically this cup's quite strong, so it's going to pop open. But with a softer cup, you basically nudge that open inside of you, and that will help you to open up the cup. If you've managed to use, say, the punch down fold and got the cup in this far, it's opened up but it's still sticking out, all you need to do is take your finger and push up on the base of the cup and move it up so that it's just inside you. You can see here I've completely cut the stem of this cup off, but if you've still got the stem, you want that to be just inside you as well. Don't leave the stem hanging outside your body, it'll be really uncomfortable. So those are my three main tips for inserting a menstrual cup. Relax, use lubricant, and try different folds. Over time it will become easier for you, but when you start off it can be a little bit tricky. If you're having any difficulty with other issues, have a look through my other videos because there might be something on there to help you as well. So I hope you found this video helpful, guys, and thank you for watching. Bye bye.